Hi Virgo, welcome back to my channel, Queen of All the Trade. It's your girl, I'm a supermodel. So today I have your November monthly 2018 reading. Before I get into your reading, I have a few announcements. So basically, on Monday, November the 5th, okay, this Monday coming up, I'm going to be doing a live video, and I'm going to be, some of you guys are, on contemplation mode right now. You're not sure what it is that you want to do currently, but I felt like I had to say that because it just flipped out. So, what did I want to say? Oh, so I'm going to be doing a live reading on Monday, okay? So any questions that you have that you want to ask, you can ask those questions when I go live. If you want to leave your questions in the comment section below, I would like if you do that. Also, I would like for you to follow me on Instagram so that you can be updated on what's going on with me in the channel. And also, I would like for you to follow my Facebook group. I do weekly readings over there, and it's called Mystic Model Tarot. All the links and everything is in the description box down below. Okay, and please subscribe to the channel, you know, if you like to, so that you can continue to get more content from the girl, okay? And like this video, alright? Alright, and see your reading. So, let's get this music going so that I can get the energies for your, so that I can get this energy. And if you hear noise in the background other than this music, this is my kids playing. Okay. Please grab a message that you have for my Virgos. My Virgo subscribers and viewers. What is it that you want my Virgo subscribers to know? How is my Virgo feeling currently? What is my Virgo's current energy? What is the person that my Virgo is thinking about? What energy is they bringing? What are the energies from my Virgo's past situation? What are the energies from my Virgo's present situation? What are the energies from my Virgo's future situation? What are the energies for the outcome that is meant for my Virgo's for November 2018? So what is the advice that you would like? Thank you so much. Thank you so much for these messages. And this is for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Do you ever just really much in my heart, girl. Okay. All right. So let's get started with you guys. So Virgo, okay. The romance angel message that I just pulled, it says free yourself. It says it's time. Oh, sorry. I just had a whole brain fart about something. Because looking at what I see in the spread, like, I can obviously see why this would say that. Okay, so it says free yourself. It's time to take back control of your life. Okay? It's time to take back control of your life. We have deception. It says someone is wearing a false mask in this relationship. We have engagement. It says your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. Okay, that's for some people. Some of y'all need to hear these messages. Okay. All right, so let's get on to the reading. The overall energy we have is the Seven of Swords. Okay, so the Seven of Swords is all about somebody, you know, being sneaky, trying to doing something that they ain't supposed to be doing. Okay, so this can be a thought. Somebody could be thinking about being sneaky and doing something that they don't, you know, that they shouldn't be doing, basically, okay? Ooh. So basically, Virgo, this is your current energy, presently. So you're in a devil energy, okay? And I'm going to clarify that. So you're currently in the devil energy, okay? Your partner or the person that you're thinking about right now, they are in the Six of Swords energy. So basically, either this person is feeling like giving in, this person finally feeling like giving in, or this person could be carrying a lot of baggage or something of the sort. So I'm going to start clarifying. And at the bottom of the deck, we got the Knight of Cups. So basically, somebody is being sneaky about a romantic offer. So this Knight of Cups is clarifying that sneaky energy, okay? That Seven of Swords. So let's get right into it, because this devil energy, this is the energy that you're in right now. It's like a lot of toxicities, like bad habits, addictions, things of that sort. Whatever your bad habit could be, or whatever you're addicted to. Why is this devil here for Virgo? Here it is. Death. Death is an ending. So maybe you're putting a maybe you put an end into a toxic situation because this person was being sneaky. Okay.
Mommy,
so maybe you put an end into a toxic situation, okay? And I'm gonna clarify that.
Mommy,
please
come out.
Here it is. The star. So in some cases you're just putting an end into this toxic situation, okay, and it can be with an air sign. Or the other way that I see is that you're putting an end towards this toxic situation and you hoping and praying that that you can come through with this toxic situation. Why is the star here? Why is the star here, Dex? Yeah. You feeling the loss. Can you close my closet door back, please?
Oh my God. Hi, kid.
Shh. Oh. Okay, Yeah, and you feeling sad because this person that you was dealing with, they was your wish. That's what I see. So currently you're putting an end to this toxic situation with this person because they was being sneaky and you know about it, okay? So that's already revealed. They was being sneaky and you know about it and you feeling sad because this person was your wish. This person was the person that you wanted, okay? So the person that you're thinking about or dealing with, okay? They're feeling like surrendering and giving in, okay? Or they could be carrying on baggage. So let's clarify. Let's clarify the Six of Swords. Why is the Six of Swords here for Virgo's partner or person that they're thinking about? Why is the Six of Swords here for Virgo's partner or person that they're thinking about? Why is the Six of Swords here? Why is the Six of Swords here? Damn, you tell me. Why is the Six of Swords here for this person that Virgo's partner, the person that Virgo was dealing with or thinking about? Why is this here? This the Queen of Coins. They thinking about giving in and surrendering, okay? Maybe they had baggage and he was dealing with this is you, Virgo, the earth sign, you the Queen of Coins, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So they may be thinking about giving in to you. Like surrendering to you. Like it could be a situation where they had did something that they weren't supposed to do and you had got on their shit about it. Because basically, you know, you basically said, we're going to cut this out. We're going to cut this off if you can't, you know, stop with the bullshit, with this toxic shit. Okay? So they're currently thinking about surrendering and giving in to what you request of them. Okay. Why is this Queen of Coins here? Here it is. The Page of the Page of Staffs. Because the Page of Staffs is all about like finding things out, discovering new things, embarking on new territory. Just doing something new. He's very adventurous. So basically, you know, he's standing strong and, you know, he basically discovered that, you know, you're not playing no games with him currently, okay? And he wants to give in to you. He wants to give in to the demands that you're making of him, or if it's a she, you know, she, whoever it is, whoever the person you is, they want to give in to the demands of what you're, you know, demands of what you're offering. So you must have offered them some type of ultimatum or something like that, okay? So basically in the past, we have the Fool, okay? So the Fool is all about new beginnings, starting off something fresh and brand new, you know, in your life, you know, embarking on a brand new journey. So I get this. I'm not going to clarify the Fool. And then currently, okay, in your present energy, you have the Nine of Cups, okay? So somebody is getting their wishes fulfilled here. And I believe that your wishes is being fulfilled because you gave this person an ultimatum, okay? I believe that you gave him an ultimatum about this toxic shit, okay? You told him that they don't cut out all this sneaky behavior and everything that you're doing, we're going to be done. It's going to be over. And you're contemplating and sad about the fact that you kind of regretting that you had to give him this ultimatum, but it had to be done. It had to be done because this person is your wish. You wish that this person take this shit seriously. So currently, your wishes are fulfilled. And for some of you, you was happy to get rid of this person, okay? Some of y'all was happy to get rid of this person. And in some cases, this person is trying to come and wave the red flag, or the white flag, I guess. It'll be like, oh, I surrender. I'm sorry. You know, they want to come back and apologize and all that to you. And you like, look, I didn't went and did something else. I'm embarking on a new territory. I didn't found something else. That's for some people, okay? Clarify the Nine of Cups. Clarify the Nine of Cups, please, for Virgo. Here it is. The Hermit. Yeah, your wishes are fulfilled. You're going up within, retreating, thinking. Clarify the Hermit. Yeah, currently your wishes are being fulfilled right now. Clarify the Hermit. Strength wanted to come out. Some of you need to have strength currently dealing with this person. Ooh. Here we go. The Queen of Cups. So your wishes are fulfilled. You're going within and trying to figure out what it is that you want from this situation emotionally, okay? Like I pulled it before, the Hangman. I said some of y'all is going within currently, like, and thinking and contemplating. So this is like the Hangman, okay? Except for the Hangman is just giving the fuck up. Like, the Hangman just hanging there. He can get his ass out of them damn ropes. You know, hanging upside down when he chooses not to. He's just like, okay. You know, I'm over it. And that's just probably how you're feeling right now. Especially dealing with this this person and this devil energy, you know, dealing with all this toxic energy. Like, you just feeling done. Like, you tired of the shit. You tired of the sneakiness. You're just tired of it. You're just tired of it. And currently, you know, your wishes are fulfilled because apparently y'all must be separated. Or y'all not dealing with each other right now. And you're going within and thinking and wondering, you know, whether or not, you know, you're trying, whether or not, you know, you should continue to have compassion for this person. Wondering whether or not, wondering whether or not you should continue to have compassion for this person. Wondering whether or not, wondering whether or not, you know, to figure out whether or not you still love this person. But ultimately, your wishes are being fulfilled because, you know, you're happy right now just being in hermit mode. You're happy just being in hermit mode to have the peace. You know, the peace to sit down and think, the peace to have the peace of mind. And that's why that song came out, because they like, have you ever crossed your mind anytime? This person is thinking about you, and they want to know if you think, if they crossing your mind.
She's not, we have to be ready. She's
coming
in 20 minutes.
So they wondering if they're crossing your mind. That's what they're thinking. Y'all see my kids trying to photobomb. And I'm not recording this video, so they're going to have to be in the video. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, because they making me lose my train of thought doing this. They know that I don't play that kind of mess. And they've been doing this all day since while I was recording, too. Just being smart. So, basically, yeah. So, what was I saying? Yeah, so you happy just going to retreat mode, okay? And currently, you know, thinking about these things. So in the future, the future situation, I see we have the Seven of Coins. So I see that you maintaining and balancing something. Okay, let's clarify. Why is this? Here it is. The Hanged Man came back out again. I see that you're going to try to maintain and be in this standstill. You're going to try to maintain the standstill energy. Why? Clarify the Hangman, please, for Virgo. Clarify the Hangman. Like, you feeling stuck. The world. And so think, yeah, because I just seen the Wheel of Fortune too. Because you're ready for it to change. You're ready for the world to turn. You're ready for something new. You're going to maintain in the standstill energy until something new come along. You wanted to change. That's why you feel some type of loss and regret about giving this person this ultimatum, because it was your wish. Like, you really wanted this person. Okay? And this person is thinking about surrendering and giving in to you. This is you as the Queen of Pawns. And this could be them as the page of Wands. They could be an air sign. Or you could be dealing with a water sign. But I see air and water here. Yeah. I see air, water, and earth. I mean fire. I think, yeah, he could be a fire sign. I see all the signs, actually. So basically, for this future, you know, you're going to continue to maintain, you know, your composure and be in the standstill energy until the world turns in your favor. So the outcome, I see, the outcome, we got the Eight of Swords, okay? So for the outcome, you're mentally trapped in your mind. Somebody could possibly be in prison, like actually going to real prison, because this devil energy is in play on the board here. And then I see that somebody is surrendering. Okay, so in some situations, this isn't for everybody, but I'm going to say this only because I see it. So, in some situations, okay, somebody did something that they wasn't supposed to do. They was being sneaky and just basically doing something that they weren't supposed to do, okay? But they knew that was wrong. And it was toxic. Okay? It was really toxic. And because it was toxic, that's what caused the ending between y'all in this situation. Okay? And I see that this person... And I see that you're sad because of this ending. Because it had to end, okay? And I also see that the person that you're dealing with, they're surrendering. So they're like waving a red flag. Like basically they're probably like turning themselves in, or they got caught for doing something illegal. They got caught for doing something illegal. Which landed them in prison. Or landed them in jail. Okay, that was for somebody. And I just had to say it because that was for somebody. Okay. So let's find out why this Eight of Swords is here. Why is this Eight of Swords here for the outcome for Virgo? Why is this Eight of Swords here? We have the Four of Wands in reverse. And we have the Five of Coins. For some of y'all, yeah, for some of y'all, because in that situation where I just mentioned that one of y'all partners or somebody had did something they weren't supposed to do, and, you know, the situation is ending because the person had to give in, you know, turn themselves in. Like, you're, you know, you maintaining what you got to maintain by yourself. You see you carrying all these pentacles on your back. You handling that by yourself. Because this person had to go. This person got arrested. Okay? And in some cases, I see that this person is mentally trapped in their mind. Okay? They're trapped in their mind, worrying and thinking, okay, about the failed their failures in this marriage or this partnership, okay? Because they were sneaky and they did something that they weren't supposed to be doing, okay? And they're in their mind trapped because now they feeling the loss. They feeling the loss of it. They're going to feel the loss. Okay? They feeling the loss. They looking down the water. Looking at their own reflection like, damn, what the fuck? Like, I didn't lost it all. I didn't lost my marriage. That's why it's upside down. I didn't lost my partner. So that song, that Brahman Knight song, that person is like thinking about you, wondering if you're thinking about them. But a lot of y'all in this situation is happy to get rid of this toxic energy. Even though this person wants to surrender and give in to you. Even though this person wants to surrender and give in to you. And even though it was hard for you to let this person go due to the toxicities. Because this person was your wish. You good. Like, you happy. Because this is your present current energy. Like, presently, your wishes are fulfilled. You feeling as though, you know, you just started a new beginning somewhere else. You started a new beginning somewhere else. So your wishes are fulfilled. But you are going to hermit mode and you are thinking about whether you are thinking about the emotional attachment that you had to this person previously. Because the person is trying to surrender and give in to you, okay? That's for some people. They're trying to surrender and give in to you and you're thinking about it, you know, whether or not you should deal with the person. But you happy, like, you currently happy. And you're going to figure out how to maintain this. Like, you're going to maintain all of this, okay? And even though you're going to be in the hangman energy, you know, which is basically trying to give up, you're not, because the world is going to turn in your favor. You're in the hangman energy because you're doing all this by yourself. But the world is going to turn in your favor. It's my kids leaving. They ready to go for the weekend. Okay. In the future, I see that somebody is feeling trapped in their mind about the loss of this relationship. And it's most likely the person that was toxic. This can be you, Virgo. Because I see the toxic energies on your end. But I also see a death. So maybe you put an ending to the toxic energies. Maybe you put an ending to the toxic energy because maybe both of y'all. Maybe y'all both was sneaking around and doing shit that y'all weren't supposed to be doing in this relationship. Maybe y'all both was doing that. Because it ended because of the addictions, because of the toxicity, because of the cheating, because of the, you know, whatever you was doing that was too much, that you was overdoing, that was taking over the relationship. That's what it ended because of. And you're currently sad about that, okay? And you hoping and wishing that shit is going to turn around. You hoping and praying and wishing that this shit is going to turn around. Because in the past, you embarked on this new journey with this person. Let's clarify the Fool. I mean, I don't really need to clarify the Fool, but I just want to see what else happened in the past that leads to this toxic shit. The Six of Cups wanted to come back out looking back at the past. Ain't that what I'm doing, looking back at this past? Clarify the Fool, please, for Virgo. I want to know, how did they come to this toxic energy with this person? Here it is. The Nine of Coins. So, this is all about financial stability, being stable, you know, being structured. So, basically, there was a new beginning where he was financially situated and stable. Clarify the Nine of Coins. So in some cases in the past, y'all was financially situated and stable, and then it came to a point where you wasn't. So somebody had to make a choice, okay? Either you were the partner to do something that you weren't supposed to do that landed them in the situation where he was actually locked up in jail. That was for some people. That was for the jail. The person, why I said your person must have went to jail, okay? Because y'all was financially stable, like y'all was stable. You had a new beginning, you were stable, and what it is that you wanted to do in the past. Clarify the nine. Okay. These two cards wanted to come out. The Four of Swords and the Knight of Wands. So basically, with this two, you were stable, and then somebody is contemplating and resting and thinking and think mode. You were stable. You was contemplating and resting and think mode about moving full speed ahead towards somebody in a passionate way. Okay? Because the Knight of Swords is, the Knight of Staff, he is about, like, he real passionate. He come in and out. Like, he a player. You know, he's just very passionate. Okay? And he moving full ships ahead. Okay? So you would think somebody is contemplating. So somebody was stable. It was a new beginning. Y'all was stable. And then this person. And then it caused y'all to have to think and rest and meditate on somebody coming forward passionately. Yeah, somebody coming forward passionately. Or somebody coming forward and coming out with what it is they was hiding passionately. Yeah, because we got the Three Cups. And this could speak to a third party. Okay. I was going to clarify, but I just picked it up and I've seen it. So yeah, that's what happened in the past. So basically it was cheating going on. A lot of toxic shit, and currently, like, some of y'all is happy that the shit is over with, and some of y'all give your partners an ultimatum, because I see the partner surrendering to you. Okay, this is you as the Queen of Coins, Virgo. I see the partner surrendering to you. And coming to you as the Page. Because he's finally starting to realize that you was right. Or he's starting to realize that the shit that he did was wrong. Yeah. He's starting to realize that the shit that he did was wrong. And that's why in the future he's trapped mentally, because he know that he fucked up in this situation. And he's feeling the loss because you ended it. You ended the shit. Like, you put it to an end. So basically, for the advice portion, we have the Six of Coins. So that's about balancing things out. Balancing things out, giving to this person equally, sharing. So let's see, why is this disappointing for the advice for Virgo? Why is there Six of Coins here for Virgo and the advice? Yeah, because currently with some of y'all, now that this shit didn't end it, like, your wishes are being fulfilled. Like, I mean, not saying that they're completely fulfilled, but right now, you're content. Like, your wishes are completely fulfilled. You're content going within, you know, because you have emotional peace. You have emotional peace dealing with this toxic shit. We have the Ten of Swords. So this is basically saying you're giving some type of equal give and take with somebody. That's basically betraying you. That's being deceptive. Why is this Ten of Swords here? You basically trying to give some equal give and take to somebody that stabbed you in the back. Who wanted to come out? The Sun. Yeah, the Sun would make sense. You wanted to come out. Some of y'all wanted to get, yeah, and then Judgment came out. So some of you, you know, want to give an equal give and take to somebody who stabbed you in the back. And when the Sun came out, that was a rebirth so that shit could be redone, restarting over, okay? And also, this Judgment just popped out. So you want to make a judgment call or whether or not you want to keep giving to this person that's betraying you over and over again. Because like I said in the beginning, it looks like you gave this person an ultimatum. It looks like you gave them an ultimatum. And it's basically saying that you have the control. That's why this Empress here is because the ball is in your court. The ball is definitely in your court in this situation. You have the control. You have the power. Okay? That's why I was saying, like, in the beginning, you must have given this person an ultimatum. Some of y'all did. Some of y'all gave this personal ultimatum. In the end, some of y'all was happy that a judgment was made. Y'all made a judgment to cut this person off with this 10 here because you was tired of giving them an equal give and take. Some of y'all are going to continue to help this person. You're going to make the judgment call and continue to help the person that backstabbed you and that was being sneaky, okay? Some of you are going to do that. Because for some of y'all, this person was your wish. This person was the person that you hoped and wanted to be with. And because the person came back and was surrendering his white flag to you, you know, he was basically saying he complies with the, you know, with the ultimatum or whatever it is that you had gave him. He's complying to it. I mean, whatever choice did he have? He was fucking caught. And I showed y'all the three cups. I don't got it on you no more because it was at the bottom of the deck. But yeah, he feeling caught because, you know, he fucked up and did some shit and lost. He fucked up and did some shit and lost you in this process. So yeah. So I see everybody here. I see fire. I see water. Air. And earth, definitely. So I see a lot of everybody here. So basically, with the romance angels cards, let's tie this all in. So basically, engagement. It says your love life is ascending to a higher level. So with this engagement card here, like I said, for some of you, you're going to end up taking this person back. Because you're going to make a judgment call and you're going to decide to get some type of equal give and take with this person, okay? And most likely level the relationship with this person, even though this person betrayed you. So you see something in this person that nobody else sees, okay? And you're willing to give this person another chance. You're willing to give this person another chance to start a new beginning with them, okay? So that you can get your wishes fulfilled with this person. Because emotionally, you are connected to this person. You really love this person. Okay? This person is your wish. Deception. It says someone is wearing a false mask in this relationship. Okay? So for some of you, yes. Like, for some of you Virgos, this person was clearly being deceptive. Okay? And, you know, we see that with the sneaky, lying, cheating behavior, which is the overall energy of the read. We see that with this devil toxic energy in this reading. We see that you ended this shit because the person was being deceptive. Or that you need to end it because this person is being deceptive. You know, and you probably can't take the shit no more. Who knows how many times that it happened? You know, they making you feel all sad and depressed. They're just being deceptive. Yeah. And you kind of tired of it. For some of y'all is tired of it. And y'all already in your element where y'all contemplating y'all good with where y'all at. You know, because some of y'all have been let them go. Some of y'all let them go and y'all maintaining this shit by yourself. Y'all holding it down on your own and you cool with it. You cool with it. Because some of y'all see a new beginning coming. And that's for the ones that completely let go of the person that was deceiving them. And don't want any more ties with them. Free yourself. It says it's time to take back control of your life. Okay, definitely. It's definitely time to take back control. What did I say with the Emperor? The ball is in your court. Didn't I just say that when I had pulled all this? The ball is in your court. It's time for you to take back control over your life. Don't let this person drag you down. Don't let this person drag you down. Yeah, don't let this person drag you down. Because you have the opportunity to turn this into this. Okay, to have this loving soulmate partnership with somebody, anybody if you're choosing. But the ball is definitely in your court, and that's why this judgment is here. You're going to make the final judgment. So Virgos, I hope that this reading helped you guys in your situations. I hope that this really helped you guys out a lot. I see a lot of this stuff going on. I see a lot of it actually going on in my situation. You know, I'm not a Virgo, but yeah, and I mean, it is kind of disappointing when you have to deal with somebody that's, you know, deliberately hurting you over and over again. And, you know, you really want to be with this person and you just don't know what to really do about the situation. But overall, you know what to do. Because I see it here. You was in hermit mode and you thinking, you contemplating, and you trying to figure out what it is that you should do in this situation. So if this video resonated with you guys, please like the video. Please subscribe to the channel so that you can continue to get more content from me. And I'll see you guys in the next video.